Morning, boys and girls. Wanted to read you a book called A Camping Spree with Mr. Magee. It's by Chris Van Dusen. It's always nice to think about holidays when it's cold and wet, isn't it? Early one morning at 7:03, Mr. Magee and his little dog Dee packed up the camper. It's like a caravan. And hitched up the load, hopped in the Rambler, I think that's his car, and then hit the road. They drove to the mountains far from the sea for two nights of camping, or possibly three. There they are. There's nothing like camping, said Mr. Magee. I know you'll love it, just wait and see. The views are fantastic. There's hardly a sound aside from the wildlife. There's no one around. And the air is so sweet, you'll sleep like a dog, said Mr. Magee to his small, like a log, said Mr. Magee to his small spotted dog. There's Dee the dog. A few hours later, they took a sharp turn right and found a great spot to lay camp for the night. It was high on a hill with a beautiful view of Mount Adams, Mount Lincoln, and Jefferson too. It's in the States. But perhaps the most wonderful feature of all was the brook, reed stream, that ran over a steep waterfall. As the embers went out, they felt tired and dozy. So they climbed in their bunk beds, all comfy and cozy. And while they were falling asleep without care, there came along a stumbling, bumbling bear. A kindly old bear whose sight wasn't so clear. He couldn't see far and he couldn't see near, but he could smell marshmallows, sticky and sweet. The smell made him hungry. He wanted a treat. He sniffed out the place where the marshmallows lay, but the car and the camper were in the bear's way. Yet that didn't stop the sneaky old snitch. He simply tried squeezing right under the hitch. Which is where the camper fixed the car. And as he was shimming into the gap, he pushed up the hitch, which let go with a snap. Uh-oh. Now that camper and car were untied, they started to roll down the rocky hillside. The car bounced away on the old logging road, while the camper was heading to where the stream flowed. It flew down the hill in a wild wild, bumpy ride, with Dee and Magee sleeping soundly inside, like a log. They were snoring and snoozing, enjoying a dream, when splash went the camper right into the stream. The splash took the camper, then bumped out of bed. The splash shook the camper. They bumped out of bed. Now what in the world was that? Magee said. And when he looked and saw where they were, his hair stood on end, and so did Dee's fur. They were caught in the rapids, but that wasn't all. They were headed smack dab for the waterfall. Dee and Magee had both started to quiver. As faster and faster they went downriver, and just when they thought they'd fall over the edge, their camper got stuck on a rock at the ledge. So there they were, stranded. Magee and his pup on the top of a waterfall, 50 feet up. Meanwhile, that nearsighted bear from before was searching for one little marshmallow more, as bears do. When lo and behold, as if out of a dream, he spied something sweet floating over the stream. But what the bear thought was a marshmallow treat was really the hitch and not something to eat. This is the hitch. It's the tow bar. The bear was determined to capture his prize. He jumped into the water right up to his thighs. He splashed through the stream to the edge of the fall and snatched up the trailer hitch, camper and all. Dee felt a tug. Magee heard a knock. And the bear pulled the camper right off the rock. He dragged them both all the way back to the bank, where then he realized the hitch was not sweet, but quite rank. He spit out the hitch and left in dismay. Well, Magee and Dee, campers again, were all the way. It flew down the path with a jolt and a jar. Uh-oh. And stopped in some bushes right next to a car. Dee popped her head out. Magee looked out too. Had they really stopped rolling? Could it be true? All things were quiet and peaceful and still. They hooked up the hitch and drove down the hill. And on their way home, Magee said to Dee, the trip wasn't quite what I thought it would be. So when they got home with sky turning red, they decided to camp in their backyard instead. Well, that was quite an eventful trip, wasn't it? Do you have eventful holidays like that? Thank goodness for that bear. Well, the bear got them into trouble, but then the bear got them out of trouble. And then thank goodness for things like sitting out at night, and fires, and marshmallows, and other delights. You sort of get into the rhythm of this rhyming business. Anyway, I hope you have good dreams and good plans for some nice break when the weather's better. Every blessing. Bye.